Hi everyone and welcome to ILAN Technologies presentation, and today we'll be looking at OpenVPN and how we can use it to set up a dial-in VPN with supported DrayTek routers, which includes all of the current models with built-in VPN tunnels. My name's Darren and I'm the Queensland sales rep at DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. We'll start by looking at what OpenVPN is and how it works, and we'll also look at the advantages and disadvantages. Then we'll go through the configuration process to set up a dial-in OpenVPN tunnel using a DrayTek router and the DrayTek SmartVPN client. And I'll also take you through a demo of that process. If you have any questions during the video, please comment in the chat box on the right of the screen and stick around at the end for a 5-minute Q&A session. Don't forget you can pause the video or skip back any time if you'd like a longer look at anything or to hear it again. If you're watching this after the live premiere, please comment below or send an email to sales@draytech.com.au. So what is OpenVPN? Well, OpenVPN is a type of virtual private network or VPN used to create secure point-to-point or site-to-site connections. One of the big draw cards for many people is that OpenVPN is open source. That means its code isn't owned by anyone and anyone can look at it. There's a worldwide community involved in continuously improving and modifying it, so any problems are quickly found and ironed out. It's also capable of traversing NAT and firewalls, which means less headaches for system administrators and end users. Like other VPNs, OpenVPN allows peers to authenticate each other using pre-shared secret keys, certificates, or a username and password, which is a familiar process for most people who work with VPNs. Note that OpenVPN is an SSL VPN, so it can't be used for IPsec, L2TP, or PPTP VPN tunnels. How does OpenVPN work? OpenVPN uses the OpenSSL library, which is an open source toolkit used for encryption and to generate security certificates. It can use either UDP or TCP to transmit data, but it works best over UDP. UDP is a little less stable than TCP, but it's faster, which is why the OpenVPN server first tries to establish the VPN using UDP. If those connections fail, then it'll try TCP. It uses a custom security protocol utilizing SSL and TLS for key exchange. By default, OpenVPN listens on port 1194 UDP and TCP, but port 443 TCP can also be used. So, some of the advantages and disadvantages of using OpenVPN. On the plus side, OpenVPN is a very secure protocol, being able to use 256-bit encryption keys and high-end ciphers. As mentioned, the OpenVPN protocol can get through NAT and firewalls. Since OpenVPN can use both TCP and UDP, it offers more control over connections. It's also supported on a large number of platforms and also has support for perfect forward secrecy. On the downside, setting up an OpenVPN connection can be a bit of a headache, but as I'll show shortly, DrayTek have made the process fairly easy once you know the steps involved. Connection speeds can suffer due to the strong encryption used, but that shouldn't be too noticeable for most NBN connections. Another issue can be that third-party applications are needed to make it run. But even with these drawbacks, it certainly has a lot of fans, and there's a plethora of technical information out there if you'd like more detail. Because of its popularity, OpenVPN was introduced into DrayTek routers a couple of years ago. Dial-in OpenVPN became available in router models from the Vigor 2762 series. The ability to create LAN-to-LAN VPNs using OpenVPN became available in the latest router models from the Vigor 2765 and above. But in this webinar, we'll just be looking at creating a dial-in OpenVPN tunnel. The table here lists the number of OpenVPN or SSL tunnels supported in the current DrayTek router models compared to the number of supported IPsec, L2TP or PPTP tunnels. In general, you'll find that the total number that each router can manage will be half or less than half of the number of IPsec VPN tunnels, with the exception of the lower end routers at the top of the table, which can handle two VPNs no matter what type. There are many configurable parameters in the OpenVPN server setup menu in DrayTek routers, such as TCP or UDP and port numbers to construct the VPN tunnel. You can select the encryption required for both cipher algorithm and HMAC algorithm. Certificate authentication can also be selected. OpenVPN on Vigor routers only support TUN device interface, so you need to set up the corresponding configuration on the client side, but I'll show you how easy that is shortly. TUN is an abbreviation for Network Tunnel and is a virtual point-to-point IP link. It's a software feature simulating a network layer device, and it operates with layer 3 packets like IP packets. The main functions include host addressing, message forwarding, traffic control, and connectionless communication. You can also select the router generated certificate or import certificates issued by third-party certificate authorities, which you'll find abbreviated as CAs in the DrayTek user interface. In the client configuration menu, you can create and export the configuration required for a remote OpenVPN client to connect to the router. This makes the process very easy. Details such as the remote server and CA certificate details can be entered. In the import certificate menu, you can import the certificate from other places for a remote OpenVPN client to connect to the router. Okay, let's look at how to create a dial-in OpenVPN tunnel to a DrayTek router. There's 8 general steps. Those are, firstly, check that the WAN you want to use for the VPN is online. Enable the OpenVPN service. Check system date and time. Create a dial-in profile. Create certificates on the router. Export the client config file. This will have .ovpn as the file extension. Apply the OpenVPN service certificate in SSL General Setup. And finally, create a remote dial-in profile by importing the OVPN file into the DrayTek SmartVPN app, which is the software VPN client we'll be using on the remote PC to dial in. The first 3 steps are easy. First, make sure the WAN connection is online. Then make sure that Enable OpenVPN Service is selected in the Remote Access Control Setup menu under VPN and Remote Access. Then check the system data is correct in the System Maintenance menu. That's important for generating self-signed certificates, and it also comes in handy if you're using the syslog to monitor or troubleshoot. Then go to VPN and Remote Access, Remote Dial-in User, and create a new profile. You'll need to give it a username and password, and also make sure OpenVPN is selected as allowed dial-in type. Step 5 for router generated certificates is to go to VPN and Remote Access, OpenVPN, and select the OpenVPN Server Setup tab. Check if the UDP port is the one you'd like to use. Port 1194 comes up by default, but you can change it if you want to. Then select Router Generated Certificates and click the Generate button. That will generate 4 certificates, which are Root Certificate, Server Certificate, Client Certificate, and Trust Certificate. In step 6, we can now export the client config file with the OVPN extension, which will be used to configure the DrayTek SmartVPN client. Go to the client config tab, give it a name, for example, Open4, then click on export. In this example, you'll get a file named open4.ovpn. Save that somewhere where you can find it again and perhaps transfer it to a USB drive. In step 7, go to VPN and Remote Access, SSL General Setup, and select the OpenVPN server certificate you generated earlier, and click OK. The last step is to import the .ovpn file into the SmartVPN client. This will often be on another PC, so having the file on a USB drive will come in handy. The OpenVPN type will need to be selected, and then click on Import up the top right, and select the OVPN file you created earlier. The WAN IP of the VPN server with port 1194 will be automatically uploaded. Then just type in the username and password, and clicking OK will start the VPN tunnel. Note that you will need to install OpenVPN Client version 2.4.8 for Windows 10 from openvpn.net/community-downloads, or you won't see the OpenVPN type as an option in the SmartVPN client. If all went well, if you go to VPN and Remote Access Connection Management, you should see that the OpenVPN tunnel is established. You should see green text indicating that the data is encrypted. Okay, let's put all that into practice. This procedure is also covered in an application note linked down the bottom there, and I'll include that link in the description below. So I have a Vigor 2865 router here, and our online status tells us that WAN 1 is online. Step 2, go to VPN and remote access control setup, and make sure enable OpenVPN service is selected. It's a good idea to disable any services you don't need here while you're at it. Then check our system date and time is correct down in the system maintenance menu. We need this because we'll be using a self-signed certificate. Now we create our remote dial-in user profile under VPN and remote access, remote dial-in user. Here's one I created earlier, so we'll click on that. So here we need to give it a username and password. If we want it to be always on, we'll need to set the idle timeout to 0, and we need to make sure OpenVPN tunnel is selected as an allowed dial-in type. You can deselect the other allowed dial-in types if you don't want them to be options. Then we pop into the OpenVPN submenu under the OpenVPN Service Setup tab. The UDP port is set to 1194 by default, but that can be changed if you have a need to. Then click on Generate to create these four certificates, which I've already done. Then to get our client config, we go to the Client Config tab. We can set up the VPN as default gateway if we want to. The value of UDP ping means if no packets have been sent for at least 10 seconds, the router will send a ping over the OpenVPN channel to check the client side is still there, which also prevents timeouts. UDP ping exit time of 60 seconds means that after 60 seconds pass with no response, OpenVPN will exit. Then we just give it a file name we can remember later for the SmartVPN client app. Then click on Export. Downloads go into my Downloads folder by default in this browser, and there's a few other .ovpn files in there that I created earlier as well. Now we'll go to the SSL General Setup menu and select the OpenVPN Service Certificate, then click OK to exit. Okay, now let's jump onto another PC to set up the SmartVPN client. So I have a profile I created earlier here called OpenVPN 2. Let's just alter that IP address so you can see what happens. So we just click on the import button and browse to wherever we have the OVPN file created earlier. Click open and it will populate the profile with the correct WAN IP address and port number. Then just type the username and password you created in the remote dial-in user profile in the router, click OK and then connect. Actually, before I click connect, let's run a continuous ping to the VPN server, which is on 192.168.1.1. Click connect, and once the tunnel is created, we'll start to get replies. And there it goes. Okay, let's go back to the router and go to VPN connection management. Click on refresh, and there's our OpenVPN tunnel up and running, and green text means that the data is encrypted. Okay, so to summarize, today we started by looking at what OpenVPN is and how it works, along with some of the advantages and disadvantages. Then we covered the steps required to set up a dial-in VPN tunnel using OpenVPN and went through a demo using a DrayTek Vigor 2865 router as the VPN server and the DrayTek SmartVPN client as the VPN client. Okay, that's all for now, but please stay tuned. We'll be answering questions in the live chat on the right of your screen for the next 5 minutes. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02983888999. Please like and subscribe below, and if you'd like a notification anytime we put up a new video, please give the bell a click too. Thanks and bye for now.